You're watching CN2 News, your number one source for award-winning hometown coverage.
As balloons fly high here in the sky over Lake Wylie, we take time to remember a fallen soldier, one that died for our freedom 10 years ago. I'm CN2's Michael Lofredo with the touching tributes.
Handshakes, eye contact, and saying please and
thank you.
All things we know but sometimes forget because we're too busy looking at technology. I'm CN2's Renee O'Neill with how one teacher is using a friendly competition that we can all learn from at home.
As Hollywood gets closer and closer to the Tri-County, we find out more and more about who will be part of the film industry here. I'm David Metzel with their connection to major motion pictures, ones you may have even heard of.
A lot of big stories to tell you about tonight. Hello, I'm Lucas McFadden. Thanks for making CN2 News a part of your evening.
Hello, I'm Laura Bree. Monday, first up tonight, a competition like you've never seen. How do you teach the importance of a first impression? The soft skills not everyone inherently has. We get a lot of calls here into our newsroom about tours, but this one caught our attention. We were about to participate in a lesson, not just for the elementary school students coming through, but perhaps one everyone should learn. CN2's Renee O'Neill tagging along on this two-day friendly competition that started with 32 fifth graders. Let the soft skills showdown begin.
My name's Malaya.
Malaya, great to meet you.
As these 10 fifth graders from Ebenezer Avenue Elementary School walk through the doors at CN2, they want that first impression to stick.
My name is Caroline.
Good morning, Caroline. Great to meet you. Thanks for visiting CN2.
We've talked to several different people and they've talked about how students need to have those communication skills and how sometimes they don't have the opportunities to practice. So we thought that these are skills that these students will need in the real world.
At CN2, the students reading off the teleprompter, getting judged on things like eye contact, posture, clarity, and comfort.
Hello, I'm Caroline, a fifth grade student at Ebenezer Avenue Elementary School.
I think these soft skills are important because, like, when you get a job, it's going to be like your first impression, and they're going to look back at everything you did.
Kind of like it was like nerve-wracking. Like it was easy, but then like the more like you got into the script, the more easy it got.
The next stop, Williams and Fudge. Here, the students are answering questions in front of a panel. After a good night's rest, the six finalists are surprised with a limo ride to the Rock Hill School District's office. Here, the students talk with district staff on topics related to education.
Nice to meet you. My name is Chazity Nash.
And then it's lunchtime at the Pump House. Students still have to be on their best behavior as they show off their dining etiquette skills and soft skills to the judges.
Napkin down on the left where the person's sitting. The napkin would go on the left, then the fork would go on top of the napkin.
It's down to the final three.
Congratulations, you three. You still have one more final task to do.
Those students pulling up to Winthrop University Coliseum, where they have 10 minutes to write an essay and to read it in front of their peers and the judges.
They're not necessarily getting this in society today, especially not from their peer group. So it's important to teach them the importance of shaking hands and having eye contact and thanking people for what they do.
Oh, it can just take you so far. I mean, just the littlest things, just your character, build your character, learn how to interact with other people, people of all ages.
Grand champion for our first ever soft skills showdown is Mr. Hayden Balcazar.
Hayden taking first place in front of all of the other fifth graders who were also surprised with a limo ride to Winthrop.
You never know when you're going to need these skills, like especially during job interviews, meeting new people. It's just going to help you throughout the future.
A teacher with a vision teaching a lesson we can all learn from. In Rock Hill, Renee O'Neill, CN2 News.
Such an exciting experience for these kids. This is the first year the school held a soft skills showdown. Organizer and teacher James Daigle says he plans to do it again next year and make it even bigger. The winner, Hayden, is also so humble. He even added if he could, he would let all of his classmates be a winner because they all compete so well.
Well, hard work paying off for the newest heroes here in the Tri-County. 11 recruits were graduating from Rock Hill Fire Department's Training Academy this Thursday. 8 of the graduates will now be working for the Rock Hill Fire Department. 1 will head to Pleasant Valley, another to Oakdale, and 1 to the Lancaster City Fire Department. Fire Chief Mike Blackman telling us what these recruits had to go through to get to this day.
They go to a 13 weeks of training. They have physical training, which they do weights, and cardio, which they do some running, to keep them in shape and to get them in shape. And then they have classroom settings and field exercises. They go through different exercises and classes that we teach them the skills they'll need to perform their duties once they're hired on.
I'm very nervous. I'm not gonna lie, I'm very, very nervous, but I'm ready to make it happen. I know what I signed up for, and I'm very aware of that. And I've been training, you know what I mean? I'm ready for it. So.
Absolutely. The new recruits will begin their first shifts this coming weekend. Well, a soldier with no ties to the Tri-County being honored here in Rock Hill for his dedicated service to our country.
Local veterans say they wanted to honor him since his family now lives in Rock Hill. Gavin Ranke of Pueblo, Colorado, died 10 years ago this week while defending our freedom in Iraq. Gavin received many awards while in the military, including a Purple Heart. The Rock Hill community, including several members from the Rolling Thunder, releasing 100 balloons into the air, blue balloons specifically, to help remember his sacrifice. His widow and their daughter telling everyone they're so thankful to friends and neighbors who have welcomed them into our community. They say Wednesday's ceremony helps to put some closure on 10 years of pain and sorrow.
We found a family here. We really did. And, you know, family is not always defined by your bloodline. It's really defined by the people that take care of you.
Staff Sergeant Gavin Ranke would have turned 42 years old this week. His wife and daughter ended up living here in Rock Hill because they had friends already in the area.
Well, the Catawba Indian Nation meeting with more people from the major motion picture and television industries. Actress and producer Irene Bedard paying a visit to the Catawba Reservation this Thursday. She was the physical model for Disney's animated film Pocahontas, as well as the voice of the main character. Today, she's visiting Chief Bill Harris and others as the delegate for the American Indian Business Council to the United Nations. She says the upcoming Catawba movie studios could be just the thing to give 400 million Indigenous American storytellers a voice in the mainstream media.
We've maintained a lot of these beautiful stories, and we have so many things to offer, not only our own tribal communities, but our communities at large, and really the world community.
She and her associates spoke about many television shows they are already moving forward with, and they say a full-blown movie studio could bring millions, even billions of dollars here to the Tri-County. Well, the Catawba Reservation holding its first ever planned run recently. They called it the 5K River Run. Close to 170 people and 40 volunteers took part in the fun. Before runners took to the course, Chief Bill Harris held a ceremony to cleanse the race participants, and they held a drum song, trophies in Catawba pottery going to the top winners of that race.
Complete strangers joining hands and hearts for this National Day of Prayer.
Wake up,
first Thursday of every May is called the National Day of Prayer. It's a time to invite people of all faiths to pray for our country. The observance is celebrated with services across the country, including many here in the Tri-County, after being signed into law by President Harry Truman in 1952. Here in Rock Hill, a crowd gathering at City Hall to sing and pray. One person telling us there are many people we should be praying for.
For our leaders of the country, for the local leaders, that their hearts would turn toward God.
During the ceremony, different people will lead a prayer like this for groups like lawmakers, business owners, teachers, and doctors. And here's a picture from Fort Mill's National Day of Prayer at Town Hall. It happened around noon today. To date, there have been 144 national calls to prayer. This Thursday night, kicking off a big weekend of college graduations, happening at this hour, Winthrop's graduate commencement there at the Coliseum. Then on Saturday, Winthrop holding two graduation ceremonies at 10 a.m. and then at 3 p.m. The school will hand out 700 undergraduate diplomas on Saturday. Also during both ceremonies, Winthrop will hold its investiture for President Dr. Dan Mahoney to recognize the official start of his presidential tenure. Clinton College will hold its commencement ceremonies this Saturday. That's May the 7th at 3 p.m. at the Kenneth Monroe Transformation Center. And York Tech students will get their diplomas on Tuesday, May the 10th. That's at 7 p.m. at the Winthrop Coliseum. Meanwhile, USC Lancaster students have already received their diplomas, the school passing along some of those pictures. You can see them. The commencement speaker was USCL alum Nat Barber. He's a senior vice president there at South State Bank.
In just a few weeks, high schools will hold their graduation ceremonies. If you want to watch them from the comfort of your couch, CN2 News will once again be airing many of those York County high school graduations live on our sister channel, CN2 Extra. That's channel 103. We'll start on Saturday, May the 21st with the Fort Mill High Schools and then end with the Rock Hill High Schools on June the 4th. There will be plenty of replay dates. Just check the TV guide for dates and times. And here's our latest Arrowpoint Federal Credit Union picture of the day. Even though the Come See Me Festival has come and gone, people are still sharing some of those pictures with us. We love this one, taking with our favorite four-legged, or should we say two-legged, friend, Digger the dog. Want to see your photo as our picture of the day? Just email it to news@cn2.com.
Coming up later in CN2 Sports.
Playing basketball at a junior college for 2 years to better prepare himself for the next level in his athletic career. I'm CN2's Amira Spruce with how one basketball player's dream is coming true.
Plus, it's a kitchen, but with no food. Kids, though, are still able to cook up a meal. What's behind this new classroom assignment? Stay with CN2 News, your number one source for hometown news, sports, and weather. Welcome back to CN2 News. Young chefs adding a very special ingredient to their recipes.
Preschoolers at Westminster Catawba Christian School kicking up a good time in their new mud kitchen and market. The play center allowing the kids to use dirt, leaves, and other things to create pretend meals. Teachers say this type of play inspires creativity as well as helps with math skills and motor skills.
There's a cash register, so they're pretending to use money and they're learning. It's just increasing their financial literacy. It creates social awareness. They're empathizing with other people.
The kitchen was funded by a grant from Family Trust, which gives educational grants to teachers throughout York County. Here's your CN2 7-day forecast. Friday will be a tad warmer than today, with highs rebounding to near 70 degrees, and just a stray leftover shower is possible.
In tonight's digital dashboard, the Fort Mill man running across America has made it to the middle of the country. Adrian Jackson left Fort Mill 34 days ago. He's headed to Los Angeles. He's raising money for his film company, Black Force Films. In just a month's time, Jackson has reached Oklahoma. Despite rolling his ankle, Jackson is keeping on running, so far running more than 1,000 miles, and in turn raising more than $1,000 for his campaign. You can follow him. Just look for Adrian Jackson on Facebook and Instagram.
Three Winthrop University senior chemistry majors recently honored at the 2016 Outstanding Student Leadership Award from Carolina Piedmont section of the American Chemistry Society. The three ladies will graduate this weekend and will continue their education.
Lancaster and Chester County Solicitor Randy Newman supporting the law enforcement community during a law enforcement appreciation lunch held in those counties this week.
And stay with CN2 News. We've got more local news and sports coming your way next.
Welcome back to CN2 News. Women in our area grabbing a hard hat and a hammer to help others in need.
All of this part of the Habitat for Humanity's National Women's Build Week. Some Tri-County women taking off work this week to help give back to Fort Mill's Paradise community. This week, women are working on projects like painting, and many are climbing a ladder to improve the look of a home. These projects help families build strength and to shed light on the challenges faced by women homeowners. Volunteers say they're just happy to help spruce up someone else's day.
It's beyond awesome. It's very humbling. It makes us aware of our own blessings. And it makes us feel good at the end of the day that we're able to help people who are unable to help themselves.
We're going to come in and focus our efforts to really sort of help lift this community by helping individual homeowners repair their homes and really create a safe and secure environment for them.
Habitat will continue its work in the Paradise community this week and will rehab about three homes. School teachers know a thing or two about hard work.
And that's why they are being honored during this Teacher Appreciation Week. The theme this year at Northside Elementary School of the Arts here in Rock Hill, Superheroes. The parent-teacher organization helping kids with several projects, showing the love not just for those teachers but for the entire staff. Kids filling the teacher's break room fridge with snacks. They bought them breakfast one day and even treated them to a catered lunch. The kids had been taking pictures of staff members all this week to make posters of them as superheroes. They didn't even let the principal in on the secret.
I knew that they were up to something, but I did not know what they were doing. They didn't even tell me what they were doing. And so I kind of like that. They like to surprise us.
Keep you on your toes. The kids stopped by the school Wednesday night and wrote notes of praise with colorful chalk on the sidewalks in front of their school. They even have nice surprises planned for the staff every day of the week.
Ah, that's special.
Well, a community coming together, celebrating life, love, and one another.
The 10th annual Celebration Jam Project Connect, sending a positive message to families at Rock Hill's Emmett Scott Center. This was Saturday. The event put on by several volunteers and churches, providing free food, health services, and information for families. Plenty of kids' activities were organized by positive role models who hope to leave a lasting impression. One fixture at the Emmett Scott Center is the youth football programs. Coaches there say even now they remember the positive effect it had on them while they were growing up.
We've been part of this event for the past 4 years, and we enjoy doing it. It's all volunteer work,
but it's for the kids and the community. This is a great event that brings everybody together for something positive. And you see that kid later on in life, and they come back and thank you for being a role model. That's like the greatest feeling ever.
And look at this. Campbell says his coach, Perry Sutton there, who coached him when he was young, still volunteers with the team as well. They tell us Jadeveon Clowney plans to visit during an upcoming youth football camp this summer.
We have the best community right here. All right, stay with us. CN2 Sports up next.
It's a remarkable win and a long night for the Northwestern baseball team.
That in a minute, but first CN2's Damaris Bruce with a college athlete who is furthering his education and basketball career.
Former Northwestern basketball player and Clinton College hoop standout Clenzo Ross signing with Lander University this Thursday at the Charlotte Avenue YMCA. Clinton College is a junior college allowing student athletes to play for 2 years before moving up to a four-year school, giving them more time to better develop their skills. Clinzo had offers from a variety of four-year schools. He shares with us why he chose to go with Lander University.
So I really like the coach. He came from Anderson, actually. And I don't know, I just felt really at home there. They're a really good team, said they're really unselfish.
Clinzo scored a career high of 18 points against Spartanburg Methodist College in his most recent season at Clinton College. His point average was 16 points per game. Now let's make our way to Louisville High School, where the Louisville baseball team is facing Fox Creek in a double elimination game. Picking up this game at the fifth inning, Fox Creek leading 3-1. Fox Creek is up to bat and the bases are loaded, the batter making a nice hit, allowing two of his teammates to bring their runs into home base. But the Lions are not giving up and stepping up its game for a final score of 3-0. Louisville are the District 1 winners and will advance to the Upper State Championship starting on Saturday. Just across Louisville's campus, the Lady Lions softball team taking on Whitmire for the District 1 softball title. Picking up at the top of the third, Louisville leading 7-2. Emily Morton up to bat. She makes a nice hit, but gets out before she can make it to first base. The Lady Lions keeping up the momentum and winning with a final score of 10-9. Louisville will advance to the upper state bracket games starting on Saturday. Staying with softball, the Fort Mill Lady Yellow Jackets facing Dutch Fork in a double elimination game, hoping to get back into the playoffs bracket. Dutch Fork at the plate making a hit, but Fort Mill's defense is no match and is able to get the game back in its hands. Lady Jackets' Marissa McDermott up to bat. Dutch Fork's defense misses the opportunity to grab the ball, allowing McDermott to make it to first base. Final score, Fort Mill 10, Dutch Fork 0. The Lady Jackets are facing Boiling Springs in a doubleheader right now for the District 1 championship title. Kicking over to Bob Jones Stadium, where the Fort Mill girls varsity soccer team is taking on Wade Hampton in the second round of playoffs. The Lady Jackets coming off of a shutout victory against Easley. Wade Hampton putting up some good defense, preventing Fort Mill from scoring in the first half. But the Lady Jackets would make a comeback and put up a fight, winning the game with a final score of 1-0. Fort Mill will face Dorman at home on Friday. That's tomorrow at 7 p.m. in the third round of playoffs. The Northwestern baseball team facing Lawrence in an exciting elimination game to fight for the District 1 championship title. The game lasted for 16 innings with a walk-off sack fly from Andrew Shipman and a wild pitch from Cam Smith. Northwestern will move on to the upper state championship bracket starting on Saturday, continuing its journey towards a state championship. Making a stop at Indian Land High School, where the Lady Warriors soccer team is hosting Woodruff. The Indian Land girls soccer team has only had 7 goals scored against them the entire season and have shut out many of its opponents. The girls are currently the #1 seed in the 2A classification for upper state. The Lady Warriors offense is on fire against Woodruff, shutting them out with a final score of 4-0. Indian Land will host Christchurch on Friday, May 6th at 7 p.m. Winthrop track and field standout athlete Marthalene Cooper setting a facility record and continuing her winning ways at the Liberty Twilight meet. Marthalene had a distance of 62.74 meters in the hammer throw, adding to her other top national throws of the year. Head coaches say that this meet was a great way to shake off the post-final exam stress, bringing out many other top performances by Winthrop athletes. Breaking records and making history. In Rock Hill, Damaris Bruce, CN2 Sports.
All right, thanks, Damaris.
And we want to mention, of course, the South Carolina Strawberry Festival taking place Friday and Saturday, and police letting us know a portion of 160 there in the downtown Fort Mill area. It's at Walter Elisha Park. It's going to be closed from 5 p.m. the road on Friday until midnight on Saturday.
Have a good night.
Good night.